APES Environmental Science Year in Review by Victoria Sun. Here we have all the units, going from Unit 1, the Living Worlds and Ecosystems, all the way down to Unit 9, ending at Global Change. I will go through each and every unit and what is composed of each unit. Unit 1, we have the Living Worlds and Ecosystems. We start with the complete introduction of ecosystems and terrestrial biomes, aquatic biomes, the carbon cycle, the nitrogen cycle, the phosphorus cycle, the hydraulic cycle, and the trophic levels. For Unit 2, we have the Living World Biodiversity. This starts with the introduction of biodiversity, then ecosystem services, island biogeography, ecological tolerance, natural disruptors to ecosystems, adaptations, and ecological succession. Next, in Chapter 3, we have populations. This includes generalist and specialist species, case-selected and R-selected species, survivorship curves, carrying capacity, population growth and resource availability, age structure and its diagrams, total fertility rates, human population dynamics, and demographic transitions. Finally, we have Unit 4, Earth Systems and Resources. This unit includes information about tectonic plates, soil formation and erosion, soil composition and properties, Earth's atmosphere, global wind patterns, watersheds, solar radiation and Earth's seasons, Earth's geographic and climate, El Niño and La Niña. Next, we have Unit 5, Land and Water Use, including the tragedy of the commons, clear-cutting, the Green Revolution, impacts of agricultural practices, irrigation methods, pest control methods, meat control methods, impacts of overfishing, impacts of mining, impacts of urbanization, ecological footprints, interest to sustainability, methods to reduce urban runoff, integrated pest management, sustainable agricultural, aquatic cultural, and sustainable forestry. Unit 6 is composed of ideas of energy resources and consumption, and renewable and non-renewable resources, global energy consumption, fuel types and uses, distribution of natural resources, fossil fuels, nuclear power, energy from biomass, solar energy, hydroelectric power, global thermal energy, hydrogen fuel cells, wind energy, and finally, energy conservation. Unit 7 is about atmospheric pollution and teaches us about the intro to air pollution, photochemical smog, thermal inversion, indoor air pollutants, reduction of air pollutants, acid rain, and finally noise pollution. Unit 8 is about aquatic and terrestrial pollution, including ideas of sources of pollution, human impacts of ecosystems, endocrine disruptors, human impacts on wetlands and mangroves, eutrophication, thermal pollution, POPs, bioaccumulation and biomagnification, solid waste disposal, and finally, sewage treatment. Last but definitely not least, we have Unit 9, Global Change, including major environmental disasters, stratospheric ozone depletion, reducing ozone depletion, the greenhouse gas effect, increase in greenhouse gases, global climate change, ocean warming, ocean acidification, invasive species, endangered species, and human impacts on biodiversity. Some of my main do's and don'ts for this class is do pay attention to class and take good notes, and do read the book. Doing both these things will lead to success while taking the AP test, and lead you to not have to study for long hours as you will already know all the information. My don'ts is do not procrastinate and put off homework for the last minute, and do not just look everything up on the internet. If you procrastinate, you will be stressed, and that is not fun, leading to more anxiety in a person. And if you look everything up on the internet, then you won't actually get anything out of the class, and you won't actually be properly prepared for the AP test. The AP class that I compared with AP Environmental Science was AP World History. The ways they are similar is that in note-taking, they both have a lot of notes to take in class and at home. Both have history incorporated into it. Well, obviously history has history, and then AP Environmental Science does as well. And for both classes,
I noticed that memorization is key. There are different in a lot of ways too. Some ways that I saw were that the tests were a lot different. AP environmental science tests, you can study more for than you can for AP world tests. Well, as study, I mean just like memorize certain things more, but AP world is kind of just like random and a lot of like stimulus style questions. APES had a lot more projects and different labs to do, while AP World History is just a lot of lectures, and once in a while you get some videos incorporated there as well. On April 14th, I took the APES National Exam. My review so far on the exam, not knowing my score yet, but I believe I didn't do too bad. For the multiple choice section, we had an hour and 30 minutes, and it was about 80 questions. This section was a lot easier than I expected, and I believe that I did pretty well. Definitely thought it was going to be harder, but it wasn't. And then for the food response part of the test, there was three questions, and this part was a lot harder for me. I thought a lot harder than the multiple choice, and I don't think I did super well on this part. At this point in time, I'm committed to Boston University. I'm currently in the CGS / London program. This is where I will be in the College of General Studies, and then next summer I will go to London for 2 months, taking courses at a building they have in England. After this, I plan on studying maybe psychology or something in business, and then going on to law school. For my college, you must receive a 4 or 5 on the APES test. This counts as 4 college credits and is the course equivalent of EE100, which stands for Earth and Environment. Some valuable skills and knowledge that I got from this course was the importance of protecting our Earth, and we can do this by recycling and just being very Earth conscious and understanding our ecological footprint and the impact that we have on our environment around us, and doing a better job to sustain the Earth, the only Earth that we have right now and that we will ever have. The second very important thing that I learned and got out of this course was how important time management is. This is very important when it comes to taking a lot of AP classes and college courses, because you will never have enough time to do anything, so you'll have to be able to manage your time properly and correctly in order to get the best out of the time that you have and to accomplish the most, because especially hanging out with friends, doing sports, and taking a lot of hard classes is a very hard thing to manage, and this class definitely taught me a lot about that. Thank you so much for everything. It was a great year, and I hope you have an amazing summer. Bye.